Comics Plus, what is going on? My name is Akasun here, the man in Japan, right back with you again. Checking in on American problems going on, I suppose worldwide, Western problems going on here. As you might have heard, there has been a bit of controversy going on with the latest game, the new game, Hogwarts Legacy, the Harry Potter IP. People protesting. Some people are very much against this game, based on the views and opinions from creator J.K. Rowling, even though she has no involvement in this game, but and there's a trans character, but her opinions on the trans community has shifted and divided fandom as to who can play the game, who can't play the game. If you buy this game, in some people's eyes, you are considered a transphobe person and you're supporting bad things and blah, blah, blah. And there's people that are like, well, just play the game. If you want to play the game, play the game. You know, there's a trans character in the game and what have you not. But the people, mighty Keef has done a sketch about this, illustrating exactly the problem with this protest, and I want you to check it out. So let's go.
Mighty Keef.
Hey there. Just here to pick up my copy of Hogwarts Legacy.
Yeah, no problem. Let me go ahead and see if we got some in the back. Hey, Jimmy! Jimmy, we still got some of that transphobe propaganda. What you talking about, that wizard game? Yeah, the franchise where you're harboring hatred and you're calling for the extermination of trans people.
You, like, do you actually believe that?
Shit, nigga, I got a fifth grade reading level. Of course I do.
Here's your game, buddy.
Oh, shit.
And it looks like you already paid with your blood money online, so you're good to go.
Blood money.
Thanks.
I love it.
Have a great day.
Dude.
You have a great day as well, evil person who hates marginalized people.
What? Sir, I'm black.
I'm black.
Why are you supporting hatred with the LGBTQIA+ community?
How did we get here so fast?
The game's the gun, and you're the bullet. The bullet's the game, and you're the bullet's in the gun.
The game's the gun, and you're the bullet. Holy shit. You know, the sad part is, I mentioned this earlier when I first started the stream on Twitch here, is literally I've seen people like that, like friends of mine who are like, hey, you know, they got their wizard stuff going on, and they're just like, I can't wait to play this game. I'm like, getting ready to start the stream, and then under the comments like, oh, so you support hatred against the trans community. Unsubscribed. Or they'll be like, well, you know, I didn't want to do this, but I guess I'm just going to have to, boom, unfollow you. And I'm just like, wow. Anyways, it continues.
You're the gun and the bullet is the game. Sorry, you're the gun and the bullet is the game and you're causing a murder. You buying this game means you directly and definitively agree with all of the positions that J.K. Rowling has on the trans community.
Bro, what the hell? I never said I share her views. I'm just trying to play a game. I don't even know what she's doing unless someone else brings her up.
Okay, but you still bought the game. You're supporting her financially.
I bought the game because it's Harry Potter. I grew up with Harry Potter, just like I'm sure everyone else my age. I don't understand what's going on. Isn't Harry Potter just bigger than J.K. Rowling?
Exactly. So it's like saying if you buy a Disney phone, or you guys probably don't even know what Disney phones are. They sell them out here in Japan. They're very popular. But if you watch Disney Plus, if you watch a Marvel movie, or if you watch Star Wars, does that mean you're supporting the annihilation of all Jewish people? Because that's what Walt Disney was into, apparently. Yeah, come on now. This dude's been frozen for like 50, 70 something years. I don't think Walt Disney and Bob Iger are going to be sharing the same sort of, outputs. I don't think that Walt Disney would have signed off on two women being married in the multiverse of madness. I'm just saying. All right.
At this point?
No. Sorry, buddy. You're supporting a billionaire transphobe. Twitter will be hearing about this.
Wait, what?
He said that with his chest, too. He said that with his chest. He's like, I'm going to go talk to the manager. Look, I'm taking it to the internet. You're going to get canceled. But not really.
A billionaire transphobe. Twitter will be hearing about this. Wait, what?
I love that.
You're using Twitter?
Here we go.
What? Isn't that owned by a billionaire transphobe? Hasn't he tweeted many times, ridiculing the ideas of pronouns and all the other verbiage that trans people would consider problematic? I don't pay for Twitter. It doesn't matter if you're paying for it. You're still using it. You're still aiding in the population growth and engagement on his website. And he said plenty of times he uses those numbers to justify his purchase.
Please remember that. So the next time somebody comes at you with that, especially on Twitter, because that's where I've been seeing it the most, you let them know about all that. Why are you on Twitter then? All right, let's keep going.
And those are the same numbers that are used for advertisers to bring money to his platform. Whatever, whatever. It doesn't matter anymore. It doesn't matter. Well, why are you so fixated on this game?
It's funny, because that's actually my question as well.
Thank you.
Why are you so fixated on this game? Out of all the revenue streams this woman has, why do you care so much about this one in particular?
That's a good question.
Explain yourself. When's the last time you stood outside Universal Studios and boycotted ticket sales? You know she gets a percentage out of every Universal ticket sold? How many times have you been out there boycotting that? What about Legos? You know how much money she makes every year from toy sales?
Yep.
You're a bad person.
Holy shit.
And Twitter told me that, so I'm going with it.
It just seems so odd to me that out of every avenue she gets money from, you decide to go after this Warner Brothers video game.
Because it's Slack Division. That's exactly, it's Slack Division. Like, I'm not trying to be one of those people. Look, I genuinely believe that if you take issue in the production of products, of Harry Potter products, then that is fine. Then just don't play it. Don't watch it. Don't participate in it, right? But the idea of you going to other people and telling them not to do something because of your opinions and your views is wrong, I think. You've, like Obi-Wan has said, you've become the thing you hate, Anakin. Like, you're just promoting hate with more hate, like that, you know? Hate begets hate. It does not beget hate. And it's like, again, it's Slack Division, because it's really easy to just post hateful stuff telling people to, I'm going to unsubscribe or whatever because of this, but to actually go out and, yeah, no, come on now. Come on now, yeah. Because I will say that people did speak out about it for Fantastic Beasts 3, but I think Fantastic Beasts 3 just didn't make money and didn't do well because of other things, particularly Johnny Depp's situation. All right.
That she's not even involved with, but I think I know why. Because it's easier. You get to get out of bed, pajamas on, go right onto your keyboard and type in Harry Potter game bad, therefore I'm a good person. At some point, these movements always get hijacked by disingenuous individuals trying to look like the good guy for some type of purpose or validation.
Snyder Cult. Oh shit. What? Sorry, allergies. Oh, fuck.
It's much harder work to get off your ass and go down there to Orlando or California and boycott Universal or Legos, or go to Japan and boycott Nintendo, because guess what? She has contracts with them too. The humongous parts of her income, y'all just overlook. The ones that could potentially actually make real change, you just overlook, because it's easier to attack this game. Now I'm hearing people are bullying innocent streamers just because they're playing this game? You've become exactly what you hate.
I just said that!
A monster. For the most part, the people getting Hogwarts Legacy, it doesn't mean anything to them except they just like Harry Potter.
Yep.
They're not sharing any views with anyone.
They wouldn't even know.
Alienating people with baseless labels serves no purpose. All it does is continue to divide everyone. Hope someday you can understand that.
You have a good day.
In the meantime, I'm gonna be in Hogwarts, bitch.
Or that's just crazy.
And I will say, dude, black people look fucking fantastic. Fantastic in this Harry Potter game, dude. They got phase, they got lineups, they got the razor sort of... I don't know exactly what I'm saying. But let me see if I can find a good example for you. One of my followers sent this to me, dude. Dude, this looks amazing. Look at that drip, dude. Look at that. Like, that's something legit. That's something legit I've seen people wear very, very, very much in real life. Like, this is, like, I have something similar to this. Like, this looks great, dude. Trans people worked on the game? Really? Oh, my God. Somebody said it looked like Miles Morales in Hogwarts. He everywhere, man. Like, this is great, dude. So, anyways, you know what? Play the game. Don't play the game. I don't really care. Luckily, I don't give two shits about Harry Potter in general. But all this hate, all this controversy has actually made me want to play the game, believe it or not. Sorry, Forspoken. I think my magical money is probably going to go elsewhere at this point now. I really do not care about this the Harry Potter franchise at all. I fell asleep on half the movies. The only ones that I liked is when a bunch of people were dying in the ones where they spoke the Freedom English, not the King's English. And but you know what? If they got some red dreadlocks in there, I'm all about that, man. I want to be a 15-year-old again. Hit the like button, share, subscribe. I'll talk to y'all on the next one. Peace!